Back in 2017, a lot of the left was so excited to see a socialist lawmaker get elected to Virginia's House of Delegates. And that individual was Lee Carter. And, you know, seeing him in power, it really sent a message to leftists across the country that if he could get elected, anything is possible. This is not someone who is being accused of being a leftist, as many Democrats are by Republicans. This is someone who self-identified as a leftist. And it was really exciting to see him in a position of power. Now, he ran for governor, and unfortunately, he lost that race. Terry McAuliffe, who was the governor previously, won the Democratic Party primary. So he lost that race, and now he's done. So he decided to take to Twitter to kind of share his experience over the course of the last couple of years, and he really confirmed something that I suspected was true, that even if it's getting better in American society to identify as a socialist and to espouse socialist views and rhetoric, in the real world, especially if you're a lawmaker, it's really, really difficult to exist as an out and proud socialist. So he writes via Twitter, "This job has made me miserable for the last 4 years. I made a lot of people's lives objectively better, but the constant assassination threats and harassment were terrible for my family and my health. I'm relieved to say that I've done my part, and now it's someone else's turn. I helped get health insurance for 500,000 people. I helped thousands of diabetic people pay for insulin. I helped legalize cannabis. I helped end the death penalty. I helped workers own their cooperative businesses. I helped people unionize. I'm going to sleep well." And he should. What he accomplished is just incredible. And he's one of the socialist lawmakers around the country that proved that their politics is incredibly effective. I mean, him, Shama Sawant, these folks are showing that when you have people power behind you, you can actually govern in an effective manner, even if you have big business and your colleagues against you. And there were so many times where he was taunted by his own colleagues in the governing body in Virginia. I mean, there was the time when somebody held up a hammer and sickle sign to taunt him. And this is not a Republican who's doing this. This is a Democrat. And also, he shared a boomer meme that Republicans made and shared about him. They were basically trying to attack him as part of this red baiting bullshit. It's just, he faced this constantly. And I'm sure that he's not even sharing all of it. And to me, it's discouraging, right? Because it feels as if it's getting more easy for people to, you know, come out as a socialist, for lack of a better word. And socialism is becoming more popular. You know, more far-left ideologies like anarchism, communism, they are getting increasingly popular in the United States. And that's going to continue as capitalism fails. But we're still not to the point where it's easy to govern as a socialist. And part of this is, I think, reason why individuals like Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Rashida Tlaib, Ilhan Omar, over time, they kind of get a little bit more, or I should say less, radicalized, seemingly. And they kind of learn to play the game in D.C. as it is, and they're not as firebrand as when they got elected. Because I think that the system just, like, beat you down. I mean, AOC even said that she felt like she wasn't even sure that she wanted to run for a second term because the Democratic Party was just so unwelcoming to her. And that's putting aside all of the threats that she gets from Republicans. So, I mean, the system itself is designed to beat you down. This is what capitalism does. So the fact that, you know, Lee Carter was there, he put up with so much bullshit for multiple years, and he was still this effective, I think it really speaks to, you know, the spirit of so many people around this country who are fighting to make the world a better place. So, Lee Carter, nothing but love and solidarity for you, brother. I think that what you did was just incredible. You created a blueprint, and a lot of people will look up to you for decades to come for inspiration, because what you pulled off, I mean, That's the blueprint. That's the map. That's what we have to do. And maybe, you know, you might not be able to have a long career as a socialist lawmaker. Maybe it'll beat you down. But if you get in there for a couple of years and you improve people's lives in a really concrete way, as Lee Carter did, that's still something that's totally commendable that should be applauded. So I absolutely am thankful for Lee Carter. You know, would I have loved to see him become the governor and one day president of the United States? Obviously, yes, but still what he accomplished should not be minimized. It should be celebrated because it is really damn hard to be a socialist in the United States of America still till this day. You know, the McCarthyite red baiting smears are going to continue to exist, but with time, things will change. They just haven't necessarily changed as much as we would have hoped to this point, but still, hats off to you, Lee Carter. You did excellent, and you absolutely should be proud of yourself.